During the creation of this educational course, the OBS team released a big 19.0 update, and later a 20.0 update, adding in some great features and fixes to the software. One such feature is the new Auto-Configuration Wizard, which allows you to easily get running with optimized stream settings without having to learn the software in and out. They're trying to put me out of a job. So if you've been looking for "here's the easy way to do it" video from this course, you're in the right place. The Elgato Cam Link takes your mirrorless, DSLR, GoPro, or camcorder and turns it into a higher quality face cam than any webcam could ever provide, without the hassle and headache of normal USB webcam drivers or their terrible settings configuration. Get an uncompressed, low latency 1080p 60 signal from your camera straight to your stream with this little device right here. Buy one via the link in the video description. I'm Meeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, regardless of auto-config stuff. We're back again with a new episode in my OBS tutorial course. I've got plenty of episodes in the playlist in the description below. If you have any questions, I have answers, and I have an introductory video explaining the premise for this course and how it works and so on. To access OBS Studio's Auto-Configuration Wizard, click the Tools menu at the top and select it. Let's walk through the different scenarios provided. Please keep in mind that at the time of recording, this tool is currently in beta and may receive updates over time, but the same general principles will still apply. First, you have the choice for optimizing for recording only or optimizing for streaming with the ability to record. Let's walk through both, starting with streaming. This first option is for if you planned on streaming to Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, Beam, and so on, but might also want to record a local copy of your streams for highlights or montages. Click Next. For video settings, you get to choose your resolution and frame rate. Do note that this doesn't necessarily mean the resolution of your stream or recorded file, but just more what resolution your games run at. Typically, this will be 1920 by 1080. For FPS, you have a couple options. You can choose a hard selection of 30, 60, 24, and so on, but you can also choose to either prefer 60 FPS over a higher resolution, or to prefer the higher resolution over a higher frame rate. So you need to choose whether you want the smoothest possible video or the most detailed and high resolution video. Typically, you want to choose the either 60 or 30, but prefer 60 when possible option. Next, you will want to input your stream information. For example, we'll be streaming to Twitch, but you have a multitude of streaming platforms to choose from, or input your own server info. You can find your stream key under Settings in your Twitch dashboard. For YouTube, the key is located in your live stream settings for either a live event or for the Stream Now tool. Never show this key to anyone, or else they will be able to stream to your channel. If someone happens to be able to see the key for some reason, reset it immediately. Copy and paste your stream key into the box. Choose your region. Here, you also have a checkbox labeled Prefer Hardware Encoding. I have covered hardware encoding in previous videos, but in a nutshell, it just uses your graphics card's extra processing power to encode the video to keep your normal CPU processor from having to do so much work for that video process. This can perform a lot better, but also doesn't look as good, at least for live streams. It looks fine for recordings. You need a dedicated NVIDIA or AMD graphics card from recent years to use hardware encoding. You can check it if you want. If it's not available in your system, it just won't use it. Click Next. If you left the box about performing a bandwidth estimation test checked in the last screen, the tool will now ping local servers to choose the best for your streaming platform. Give this a few minutes. Either way, this will also test your system's performance to determine the best possible resolution, quality, frame rate, bit rate, and so on to use for your streaming experience. You can review these changes when it's done and hit Apply Settings to use the new settings within your profile. And that's it for streaming. Run some test streams and make sure that all is working, and you should be good to go. If you do want to record your stream VODs, I do recommend making a couple of quick changes. Click Settings and go to Output. Here, I recommend changing recording format to MKV. You can use MP4, it's the most compatible format, but it's prone to corruption. If you use MKV, the files will stay intact and not get corrupted if your session crashes, but you still get to use multiple audio tracks. The default selected FLV cannot record multiple audio tracks. Then, once you've finished recording, you can go to File, Remux Recording, and convert that MKV back to an MP4 for editing if needed. I have a separate video on this process if you need it. I also recommend changing the recording path to a secondary hard drive on your system. I have a couple videos dedicated to why you should do this and the choices involved, which you can check out in the description below as well. Next, let's run through the configuration wizard for recording. You can only do this once. A second time will replace your original settings. So if you want different settings for recording one day and streaming another, you need to use multiple profiles. Go to Profile, New, and give it a name if you want to make a separate recording profile. I have a full video on profiles and their uses and stuff down there below as well. This is for higher quality recordings, whereas the streaming profile just records an exact copy of what you streamed. Again, go to Tools and click on the Auto Configuration Wizard. This time, click Optimize just for recording, I will not be streaming, and click Next. For video settings, you have the same options as before. You get to choose your resolution and frame rate. Do note that this doesn't necessarily mean the resolution that you're recording to, but more what resolution your game's at. Typically, this is 1080p, 1920 by 1080. For FPS, you have a couple options. You can choose a hard selection of 24, 30, 60, and so on, but you can also choose to either prefer 60 FPS over a higher resolution, or to prefer the higher resolution over a higher frame rate. So you need to choose whether you want the smoothest possible video or the most detailed and high resolution video. While typically you would want to choose the either 60 or 30 but prefer 60 when possible option for streaming, for recording you might want to choose the either 60 or 30 but prefer high resolution option instead. This will prioritize 1080p over 60 FPS. Up to you though. Click Next. The tool will now run a system test to determine the best recording settings for you. You can review them and click Apply Settings to begin using them. Once again, I do recommend making a couple of quick changes. Click Settings and go to Output. Here, I recommend changing recording format to MKV. You can use MP4, it is the most compatible format, but it is prone to corruption. If you use MKV, the files will stay intact regardless of computer or software crashes and not get corrupted, if that happens. But if you still get to use multiple audio tracks here, whereas the default selected FLV file cannot record multiple audio tracks. Then, once you've finished recording, you can go to File, Remux Recordings, and switch it back to an MP4 with all the audio tracks intact and not have to worry about it. It's kind of nice. I also recommend changing the recording path to a secondary drive in your system. I have a couple videos explaining why you would want to do this and the choices involved. You can check that on the description below. But that is it. The Auto Configuration Wizard makes setting up your OBS Studio settings much easier. Hopefully this helps you go through the process. I also hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button for awesome tech videos. Come follow me on Twitch and hit that follow button if you'd like. And I'm AplesVox. I'll see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.